Choya and other Namibian ministers engaged potential investors on the sidelines of Horace's global meeting at Cascais town in Portugal. He says government is in the process of introducing a number of reforms to improve Namibia's competitiveness rankings and to increase foreign direct investment. The 2018 Global Competitiveness Report ranks Namibia 100th out of 140 countries, one rank down compared to 2017.
I will intervene to fix that because that contributes to the delay in starting to do business. Some requirements of fitness certificate by a municipality. Ngoma does not have even a village council. Why do you expect a fitness certificate? Other people only want to register to do business from home. Why do you expect them to create a separate toilet or ablution facilities? All these are issues that I am addressing within the reform. So we're going to simplify it, but also to increase the real physical and tangible cooperation between BIPA, the SOE, as well as the ministry structures.
Namibia signed and ratified the African Continental Free Trade Area Agreement. The trade minister says through this agreement, the country intends to use strategic location for investors into the market of 1.2 billion people.
It goes together with what we call we need to remove barriers to effect that trade on the continent and to increase inter-trade among ourselves. We're going to remove the non-tariff barriers.
The potential investors questioned Namibia's approach towards sustained investment.
The partner is there because, as a matter of fact, we need to have some local support always. When we are financing, it's necessary to have someone for the mortgage, for everything, to support us. And this would also be very important for us.
Some hailed the country for transparency and other measures government undertook to boost investor confidence. Blanche Gores, NBC News, Cascais, Portugal.